Just made our way to Bergstein after this weekend's Norwegian Cup in Golo. So now we're here actually in Sportgestein, which is a little higher than Bergstein. And this is where we're gonna race next weekend. So this is the venue. It's like 1600 meters here, so it's not very high, but still high altitude, so we have to get acclimatized. So these first days we're just gonna take it easy and train long and slow sessions. And I decided to start doing the vlogs in English because yeah, you guys get so angry when I don't add the subtitles instantly, so this will save me some time, and I think it will be easier. So hope you all enjoy it.
Light the blunts up when I walk in the building. Hit it, baby.
This week I'll bring back the voiceover commentary as I did this summer in Toppidrettsvecka, and this time we were racing in the Norwegian Cup in Golo. Huge starting field. Next week will be World Cup in Lillehammer, so this was the Norwegians' selection race. A really high level with a lot of World Cup skiers, and my first race with the team on snow. So that was good to get a last like repetition before the winter, meet all the waxers and go through some skis and find the routines for how we'll do this winter. I had some hopes for a result, but didn't know where my level really was. Versus the Norwegians, so I had a pretty humble approach. Just tried to stay with the leading group for as long as possible, not get in any trouble, not break any equipment, and get away safely, which I did, even though it was 150 skiers. So, but luckily I had a high ranking, the course was 2.5 kilometers long, so we raced 8 laps for the 20k, and a pretty long uphill in the beginning of the lap. Here we're lapping for the second time, and going out on the third lap, I was in the one of, in the front of the group, and here we see me on the left side. I have number 12. Had really good skis, thanks to the waxers. So, I could easily like gain positions in the downhills and try to use that as much as possible to, get like a cheap race where I didn't use too much energy in the uphills. And as you see here, I tried to carry as much speed I could into the uphills, Then I knew I can go really hard in the double poling sections. It was more the uphill sections where diagonal was needed, where I know that I don't have the same level as some of the skiers, so I just had to save as much energy for those parts, and I managed to do so quite well. Here we're on our way to lap for the third time, I think, and some of the first action happened. I'm in third position here, letting my teammate go together with another skier, and to let the other guys chase him. And we had a really strong team on the line today, so Yeah, it was fun to race and cooperate a little. But here we're on the fifth lap, and Didrik Tønseth throwing his hat off. Here the show started. He was gonna grill us really hard, so I managed to keep up with the pace he set, and we got away in a breakaway. I think nine skiers in the end. So yeah, that was really real fun and inspiring to race alongside these really good World Cup skiers. Didrik won a World Cup last year, so he's very much in the in the top. And yeah, I think today he was second in the World Cup, so really high level. Yeah, finally he got away after the uphill. Here we're going down again, and I didn't do much work in the group. I just tried to stay with it because I knew like that was my limit. And the last three laps I started to struggle a bit in the long uphill. Yeah, I had to close gaps all the time, but managed to do so for the last two laps at least. Then on the last lap, I lost the group. Here we see us lapping on the last lap. Yeah, and already I have a gap up, so I had to like close it, and then I was, yeah, really on the brink of losing him already before the uphill. Yeah, Didrik won in the end. I managed to get a top 10 place, ninth place in the end. So I was really happy with that. And yeah, some of you have been asking, so I thought I would address it. And yeah, this is my take on it. So yeah, first of all, to make that clear, this is no criticism of any athlete. This is just for the Swedish Ski Federation, their communication and selection process of the World Cup squad. I have been disappointed before, for selections. Maybe the most 2 years ago when I won the season premiere in Bruksvallarna, but did not get selected. I understood the their thinking though, but yeah, of course I had hoped to ski. Yeah, this time it was different because I was already in the mix for the World Cup to Rukia after Bruksvallarna. So after my race here in the Norwegian Cup, I was pretty optimistic that this time I would get the chance, because we raced the 20K mass start, and on Sunday in the World Cup there will be a 20K mass start. So yeah, I got a call from Anders Högberg, the men's coach, after the race, and yeah, he told me they were impressed with my result, and that I was in the discussion for the World Cup in Lillehammer. So I just said I was keen on going, and yeah, they were gonna get back to me during the evening with the decision. So 3 hours later, I got a text message, which said just that I wasn't selected, and yeah, good luck in Ski Classics. So the spot had gone to a skier who I beat by 20 seconds in Bruksvallarna, and then he hadn't gone on to beat in the top 30s in Rukia. Yeah, I called Anders Byström, the national team manager, for an explanation, and got told that yeah, they want to give this athlete another shot, and could not value my result in Norway because it was not in the criteria document they have for selections. So yeah, I just think that's a lot of cap because when I read it, I find it hard to see that they can just ignore that, because yeah, here we have them. And for you who can't read Swedish, the parts I've highlighted says The valuation should always be which skiers at the time of the selection have the best shot that results in world class. So, yeah, with the fact in hand that after today's World Cup, where 9 Norwegians were top 10, I think it's safe to say that the Norwegian Cup has pretty high standards. And further, it says that there should always be taken into account which races are most relevant for the World Cup ahead. And that, I think, should apply to this race because it's exactly the same distance as will be this Sunday in the World Cup, and the Norwegians based their selection on this race. So when I then got told that I didn't even get the reserve spot, which had gone to a skier, that, yeah, he beat me with 3 seconds in Bruksvallarna, but then I was over 2.5 minutes in front of him in Norway, I just hang up, yeah, I'll focus on the Ski Classics premiere in Badgerstein now, and maybe that's for the best, but that doesn't change the fact that I don't like when I get screwed over like this. So, yeah, that's what I had for you this week. See ya.